The destruction man causes to nature parallels the destruction cancer causes to live organisms. Cancer is the uncontrolled, disorderly growth of cells within an organism, which little by little destroy it. It is caused by the failure of the mechanisms that regulate cellular coexistence, resulting in the inability of the cells to carry out their vital functions harmonically. Cancer does not appear suddenly. It is a gradual process by which cells are modified. It starts to spread in space and time. The harmonious functions of the cells change. They become aggressive and destructive. Multiplying rapidly, causing havoc and lesions in their place of influence. They spread and contaminate the healthy cells. At the start of this process, the organism does not detect the change in the cells. It supposes that they are functioning in harmony. The area affected is so small that the organism as a whole is unaware of what will, in time, lead to its destruction. So the cancer is able to grow and advance, feeding on the healthy cells and destroying them. Cancerous cells originate where there is discord and irritation, ultimately destroying the organism and so bringing about their own destruction. By contrast, normal cells live in harmony with their organism. Using cancer as a parallel example, we can demonstrate that our planet Earth is a live being which breathes, feels, and expresses itself as much as we do. In short, it has a conscience. Many of us fail to recognize the Earth as a living organism. We have separated ourselves from the planet kingdom and are unaware of our unity as one cosmic organism. We have ignored the natural laws which control us and have monopolized and exploited the four elements essential to our existence. We have ignored the natural laws which control us and have monopolized and exploited the four elements essential to our existence. Air, fire, water, and land. Without these, we perish. In the name of God. Our society is unscrupulously materialistic. We willfully ignore our responsibilities to our mother organism. We fail to acknowledge our dependency on her for our development and evolution. The undeniable truth is that the Earth is in pain. It is wounded. It is suffering from a cancer called man. Each one of us, however strongly we may deny it, is guilty of causing this disease. The mere fact that we allow our leaders to commit horrendous crimes against our planet is proof of our guilt. Deforestation, toxic waste dumping, the pollution of our oceans and rivers, our air, are all crimes to which we are accomplices. We care only for money, power, fame, and glory, and we choose to ignore that the price we are paying for this is a sacrifice of our planet, of our survival. To harm our planet is to harm ourselves. The human race is creating havoc in the equilibrium of the planet as a whole. We have completely lost respect for ourselves and others. We kill, we torture, we rob, and fight wars on each other. We are creating a violence, the vibrations of which affect and are felt by the whole of creation. Our little cancer is beginning to have a disastrous effect on our very existence. Let us consider the following analogy. You are in a field. An ant crawls on your arm. You become aware of it. You tolerate its presence, provided it does you no harm. You want to warn the ant not to bite, but however hard you try to communicate this warning, he will not understand you. Is the ant even aware of your consciousness? He bites you, you kill him. We human beings are exactly like the ant. We are walking upon a living being which has its own consciousness, its own intelligence, wisdom, and functions, which obey the cosmic laws and vibrate in harmony with the rest of the universe. Mother Earth has her own language, and she uses this to communicate to us her code of natural laws, which are crucial to both her survival and ours. Instead of trying to understand, we choose to ignore her. How much longer will she tolerate our ignorance and stupidity? Just as we are able to kill the ant, so she is able to destroy us. She is warning us that if we continue our selfish abuse and destruction, she will react with all the tools within her reach. Floods, earthquakes, hurricanes, and volcanic eruptions. We must learn now to respect our planet, live in harmony with nature, and obey the code set down. Are we going to cure our cancerous cells, or are we going to allow them to continue to multiply and relentlessly wreak their havoc until they inevitably destroy the organism, our precious Earth?
And the eyes of truth are always watching you.